on an average week, if you're walking around or you're, do you walk around?
Mm-hmm. Well, I live in Los Angeles, so that's a legitimate question.
Yeah. I was in London for almost a year and a half last year doing movies, so I walked.
Yeah.
And
as you do.
Every day you get a reference to some film that you're in, yes, or somebody quotes something. What is the major thing you get?
Generally speaking, people will reference the international hits, which would be obvious ones are Batman, and Beetlejuice slowly became mm-hmm. one of those. What about you?
Well, Pulp Fiction, naturally, but...
Why do you say naturally?
Well, because people love it so much, and every year I get, like, 10 to 12 million new fans because all these kids come of age and their parents
right.
let them watch it.
Yeah.
Or, you know, they finally get to see it and all of a sudden they think it's the coolest thing they've ever seen in their lives.
Yeah.
And I'm brand new again.
Was the hair choice yours?
Actually, it became mine because Quentin actually wanted me to have an Afro wig. Mm-hmm. He wanted it to be a big Afro. So the PA he sent out to buy the wig bought the wrong wig.
Really?
So he bought a Jerry Curl wig. And
when
she came back with it, he was like, no, I told you Afro. And I was like, no, this is totally right.
Yeah, yeah.
And I put it on and we had this whole thing and he started, you know, fussing about it. I'm going, look, man, everybody in NWA had a Jerry Curl at
yeah.
that time. And this is perfect for Jules for that neighborhood.
Yeah.
And we do that. And he was like, oh,
and do you
let wardrobe determine a lot? I often do. And isn't it odd how once you put it on, you go, oh, yeah, I got it. Even though you had the character anyway, basically, once you put it on, you go, yeah, you kind of know when you're in it.
I like to make choices, not
yeah.
about, you know, the clothes specifically, but about how I want to look. It's
yeah.
like in Jackie Brown, Quentin and I had a big argument about Ordell's hair, because he was going through this whole thing about, guys don't wear their hair like that anymore. And I go, but he's stuck on Superfly.
Yeah.
He's stuck in this Superfly place.
Right.
And, you know, I want to do it. And he's like, no. So I actually paid for the wig to be made, and we put it on, and they were having a production meeting one day, and I walked through the production meeting to get some coffee or something, and they thought somebody had broken in. And when I walked over to the table, just jaw dropped. It was like, oh my God. I'm like, Ordell.
Thanks for watching Actors on Actors. Click to the left for the full conversation. Click to the right to watch our full conversation with Bryan Cranston and Jason Segel. And don't forget to subscribe to Variety's channel.